was like, oh my God, this is my song. I've been listening to the radio all night long, sitting around waiting for it to come on, and here it is. She was like, come here, boy, I wanna dance. For I said a word, she was taking my hand.
Somebody call 911. Shawty fire burning on the dance floor.
Okay, before we start anything, I think I need to do a little bit of explaining. Hi guys. Okay, all right, let's get, okay. Hi everybody, welcome back. I'm filming this after my trip to the Calgary Stampede because I think I need to kind of explain this video before I just throw it all in. You just saw the clip of me waking up the morning of the day that I'm leaving. 6 or 7 in the morning, I felt like I was slowly dying. So long story short, 2 days before I was supposed to leave, I was very sick. It wasn't COVID. It was really weird because I had like a fever and like an insanely sore throat to the point where I literally had to, like spit out my saliva because it hurt so much. My ears were also extremely itchy and dry. And then I started feeling around the rest of my body and I had like a rash, like literally everywhere. And I was like, fuck, I need to go on a plane in a couple hours. And I'm clearly unwell. And so on the car ride to the airport, I am texting with a doctor. And this is the most humbling experience of my life. She's asking me to send her pictures. So I'm sending her selfies of me. Kills me. There's no way this doctor wasn't like killing herself laughing as well. She asked for a picture of the back of my throat and I'm like, ma'am. So I have my phone like this with my mouth open and my cousin's phone in front of me so I can see, and I'm taking pictures of my mouth. My dad is killing himself laughing while driving us to the freaking airport. It was just like a complete mess. I don't even want to get into like what happened at the freaking airport. We didn't get on the flight until like hours later because they were all full, because my cousin was flying with a buddy pass, and so I could get on the flights because the buddy pass that I had is like higher level than the one that she had. And so I had to wait around until she got on a flight because I didn't just want to be like, see ya, and get on the flight without her. Yeah, so then we get to Calgary and we get to our hotel. Everything's good. My other cousin comes and picks us up and we go to Earl's. I still have a rash all over my face, but I had a pretty cool drink. I was feeling a little bit better. I think that is all I kind of need to explain right now. To this day, a full rash breakout all over my freaking, ew, I'm not gonna go that close. In Canada, you still have to wear masks on the plane and everywhere in the airport, even if you're flying still within Canada, which made my rash just so much worse. And that rash turned into a full acne breakout on my face.
Yay.
I'm also wearing my Calgary shirt. I just thought that it would match right now. So that's all I have to explain right now. Here's the next morning of me and my cousin Cassie just getting ready.
I need an extra large coffee.
Yeah, well, there's no coffee shops around here.
Are you joking me? That has to be something. No.
Well, there are, but they're like half an hour walks.
That is lawsuit worthy.
Wait, what are you going for breakfast? There's gotta be coffee in
here. Oh, we are? Why did I have my pizza? I had to take my Advil, that's why. Or like, you don't have food with Advil, doesn't your stomach hurt? Just such a joke. I didn't want to have pizza at 9 a.m., but I had to.
Heated up in a hotel microwave.
Ew! It's all-time low of this trip, let me tell you guys. Oh, they have makeup wipes here? I wash my face with this soap. I literally washed my face with that freaking hand soap that we had.
Did you actually?
Yeah. God, I'm gonna get no guys today. I'm gonna be talking to him, I'm gonna be like this. I'm gonna be like, are you okay? Do you have a rash all over your body? Yeah, but let's not talk. Whatever. I don't care. What? I got to a guy. I'm like, hey. And then he's like, absolutely not. You look like a cyclops. So. Sure. Let's go cry myself to sleep with my freaking rash all over my body. Well, the doctors would have said monkeypox, right? Very sweet lady though. She's like, oh, are you at the pharmacy? I'm like, no. She's like, where are you? I was like, none of your business, bitch. What do you need? Tell me what the hell I have. Tell me my diagnosis.
my eyeliner look even?
Yes.
Okay.
You know what? I wanted to learn how to do eyeliner, but...
It's easy. You just
no.
draw...
Has it been out of focus this whole time? Joking.
A shot of whiskey. How does, look at us harmonizing.
Oh my god, I almost ripped my mole.
You're white already.
Are you
fucking? Should I wear that small sports bra that I was wearing?
You know what I mean? Because if we're going out, can I put it in your bag and then when we go out? So I think this is good for the brunch. Okay. Fit check. Top is from?
Forever 21. I think it is.
Okay, we'll just go with Forever
21. Pants are Lululemon.
Uh-huh.
One of the Docs.
Oh,
I'm not you.
It's already going. You don't have to change. You just have to. Hey guys, top is from Aloe Yoga. Pants are from H&M. Shoes are Converse. Should I wear this top? I don't know. This one to look more like a hoe.
We're going
like
so
a.
Always the way.
That's what I'm trying to say. Wendy's coffee. How would you rate it out of 10?
10 out of 10 for now, but there was lactose in it, so I feel like it's not gonna be 10 out of 10 later.
Low key, I'd say. If you want a really sweet drink, we recommend.
The chocolate one tasted like chocolate milk.
Yeah, there's no coffee in it.
So then we made our way downtown with my other cousin and her boyfriend, and we got these super cute matching pink freaking cowboy hats, which is my new favorite thing ever. And then we head off to the biggest bar I've ever been to in my entire life. It's called Cowboys. It has a music festival, so we actually saw a drag race there, so...
Yeehaw, bitches!
Yeah!
And yeehaw, hoes! Okay, too many colors going on. Guys, I just wanted to film and tell you what Cassie just said and that she's most excited for, that there's gonna be DILFs everywhere.
Yeah, it's a stampede. It's gonna be amazing.
That's what she's most, it's gonna be amazing, guys. The DILFs are unmatched here. It's the only reason why we came to Stampede, is because there's gonna be DILFs here. Yeah. Before we get all into that, after the drag race, me and Cassie walked around the Stampede grounds. It was actually the hottest day ever, so we couldn't walk around too much, but then somehow ended up back at Cowboys. Then I ended up actually being a big mess because both me and Cassie's phones died, and thank God my brother and his friends were there that night, or else we literally would have been screwed. Next day,
wait, don't put my feet in it.
Oh, we are countried up. My cowboy shirt on. What updates do we have? I kind of don't remember what we did. Both of our phones died and we were almost stranded at this bar called Cowboys. Cowboys is actually insane. It was a little overwhelming when you got in there, but it's actually massive. Like literally, what would we have done if my brother wasn't there? I literally don't know. Look at the belt buckle. Cowgirled out. Wow. Country boy, I love you. I burned 655 calories yesterday.
Can you take a video of my fit?
Yeah. And then we're gonna go get food. Okay, bye.
Mosquito bite. Two huge mosquito bites on the back of my legs. Can you see?
I have a mosquito bite on my stomach. And a little bit of chicken thigh. Cold beer on a Friday night. A pair of jeans that fit just right. And the radio. There's no stopping me once I get going. Put a can in my hand, man, I'm wide and sober. The tick-tock of that clock is like a time bomb. You took the midnight.
Girls, making mistakes and making new friends.
So you're probably thinking, who the heck is this? No clue. Couldn't tell you. But all I do know is that he was on stage at one point playing the guitar for whatever singer was performing, and I saw him after and I said, I want a picture now. So I took a picture with him. I don't know.
Okay, don't touch the lock because then you're gonna lock me out. Okay, I'm getting ice. I don't have any shoes on. We just came back from the bar. It's actually not even that late. It's like 1:30. It's the last day of Stampede, and I wasn't trying to wait an extra hour or pay an extra $60,000 for an Uber. So we left a little bit early. I'm gonna get some ice though because they have no cold water here. Okay, I think that's good. I feel very conflicted right now. Like, look at this cute shirt. It's so cute. It's my favorite shirt. It's so cute. And my shorts, this whole fit is from Garage. Isn't that embarrassing? Do you know how many people have complimented my hat? So many. Dance, dance till you did. Jessie's phone died, and she made me write her number on her arm.
Yeah.
Wait, don't look at my number. What, did you write that?
I don't know.
Well, they spelled you wrong. I don't.
Someone wrote Tyler's a.
Yeah, Tyler's my brother. So. How did you not know that?
Also, quick reminder, Cassie is my cousin. The fact that she couldn't put two and two together, Tyler is my brother, I don't know.
I don't know who wrote that. His friend wrote that. I also was like dying of dehydration. What was I talking about? Literally, my Apple Watch thought I was working out. It said, are you going on an outdoor run? Then I won $100 on a scratch off ticket and buy a 12 pack and a tank of gas with it. Hey, Cassie, I got ice. We fly out tomorrow, but we're gonna go shopping in the morning. The house of rash
drain. What the fuck?
Still really bad.
Wait, this won't come off my arm.
Okay, I'm gonna have a shower.
Wait, I'm one number away from calling you.